So guys, once again, welcome back to Ahoy Navigos. Today we are once again back with our chart work concepts. Today we are going to discuss about the concept of doubling of angle at the bow. So let us see what is the concept. So it is a simple method for determining in advance the nearest distance that you are going to pass of a point like a beacon or a lighthouse without radar. That means if you are not having a radar or without using your radar, you can determine your position. You are off from a point that can be a lighthouse or a beacon by just observing the angle at your bow with respect to that object. So in these kinds of things, there should not be any current or tidal streams during your observation. So let us see how we go ahead with these types of things. So suppose we have a lighthouse here like this. And suppose this is your initial point, that is point A. This is your initial point, and from this you will be having some bearing to this lighthouse. Suppose that is like this with respect to your heading, that is your CTS. So you are having a CTS like this, and from your initial point you have a bearing to this lighthouse somewhat like this. Suppose this angle being 30 degrees initially. It can be anything. Let it be 30 degree in our purpose. So it's 30 degrees in this case. So what we need to know is what is the distance you will be having this lighthouse at a distance passing. So what we need to do is we need to sail on this CTS and we need to continuously observe this lighthouse bearing until this bearing of theta becomes 2 theta. It means in this case until when this 30 degree bearing becomes 60 degree. Suppose we reached at a position, that is theta. We reached at a position called B. And at this B, we took a bearing of the lighthouse and we found that it is 60 degree. That means the theta became 2 theta. That means from A to B, we sailed some distance and we reached a point where this initial theta became 2 theta. That is, in this case, it became 30 degrees to 60 degrees. So it is proven that in this case, your distance traveled, let it be from A to B, it was X distance that you traveled to reach theta to 2 theta. So the distance traveled will be the same equal to the distance off from the lighthouse at your final position. So this is nothing but you are having initially a theta and you travel some distance continuously observing this lighthouse and reached a point 2 theta. Then the distance traveled will be same as the distance of you from the lighthouse. It can be anything like 30, 60, 20, 40, 45, 90, anything. So let us see, conclude these things. If you're having initial bearing is theta with respect to your CTS, always your angle will be there with respect to your heading. That's at the bow, doubling of angle at the bow. With respect to your CTS, at A was theta initially. And you started sailing on your CTS, continuously observing same lighthouse bearing. You were continuously observing and this 30 degree became 40, 50 and somewhat point it become 2 theta, that is 60 in this case. So we reached at a point B where bearing of lighthouse became 2 theta. So we can conclude that then your distance traveled is same as distance of from lighthouse at point B. So from on your ship, you will be able to determine how much is your distance traveled from your log distance, or also you can calculate it by your time and your speed. Then if you reach at 2 theta, we can substitute that. It will become that distance traveled will be equal to your distance off from the lighthouse. So it is the easy way in which you can determine in advance what will be the distance you will be passing from this lighthouse by just observing the lighthouse bearing and making theta to 2 theta. So guys, this is the concept of doubling of angle at the bow. I hope you guys understood. If you have any doubt, you can put in comments. We will get to you. Stay tuned for more topics.